Good morning students. Today we are going to discuss about module number 1, that is introduction to power systems, overhead transmission lines and overhead line insulators. Here we are going to discuss about the topic of effect of atmospheric conditions on transmission line. So now we are going to discuss about the effect of atmospheric conditions on transmission line. So overhead transmission lines are those conductors which are placed at the outside and it is exposed to atmosphere. Once it is exposed to atmosphere means definitely it is going to subject to various amount of effects. So various amount of effects, because there is no insulation on the top of that conductor, it is exposed to atmosphere, humidity, rain and temperature. So it is affected by air, it is affected by snow falling and it is affected by wind. So the conductor gets affected by the atmospheric conditions like ice and wind. So the weight of the conductor along with these conditions also affects the transmission line, because if you take that winter season, due to the snow falling, the snow is formed like a outer surface area on the top of that bundle conductor. By that time the overall weight of the conductor is going to increase due to the placing of that snow on the top of the conductor. Hence the sag calculations under these conditions should also be considered, that weight of or the effect of ice on the conductor. Therefore the two severe atmospheric conditions on sag and the tension of the overhead transmission line calculations, it's because of, one is called as ice coating and second one is called as wind pressure. So due to that ice coating, the weight on the conductor, the tension on the conductor is going to increases, and due to that wind pressure, because wind is always perpendicular to the surface area of that conductor, definitely the wind hits that conductor and the conductor, the sag on the conductor and everything, it will be changes. Therefore there is an effect of atmospheric conditions on the transmission line. So these effects of atmospheric conditions also we are going to take into account, then only we can define the overall formula according to the effect of these conditions. So now here we are going to discuss about the topic called effect of ice coating. So when the transmission line is coated with ice, because during the winter season there is a snowfall, due to the snowfall what will happen, there is a coating of ice on the surface area of the conductor. By that time the thickness of the thickness and size of the conductor is increases. The thickness depends on weather conditions. This causes with increases in size of the conductor. So due to this placing or due to the forming of that ice coating on the surface area of the conductor, definitely it increases the size of the conductor. The increased size of the conductor may also increases the weight of the conductor and tension on the conductors, which increases that vertical sag. Already there is a sag between the two successive poles, and the sag again it is increases because of the weight of the ice on the surface area of the conductor for a given length of the transmission line. So which is also taken into account as a effect of ice coating. Then the weight of ice, which acts vertically downwards in the same direction as that of the conductor, because due to the weight of the conductor already the tension which acts, that is due to that weight of the ice which acts vertically downwards in the same direction as that of the conductor. So however the weight of the conductor which acts vertically downward direction, in similar manner the weight of the ice also vertically acts it towards the downward direction. So consider a conductor with a diameter d. So let us consider a conductor with diameter d. Here I am going to show that front view of the conductor. It is coated with ice of thickness small t as shown in this figure. So this is that small t, and actually this is that original size of that conductor, but the size of the conductor is increases due to the increasing of a thickness small t. It's because of ice coating. So due to that ice coating, the thickness of that conductor is going to increase as which is shown in that figure. The overall diameter of the coated conductor is capital D. The overall diameter of the conductor Now I am taken into capital D. Actually, the diameter of the conductor is only small d, but due to that ice coating on the surface area of the conductor, the thickness of the conductor is increases. Thereby, the overall diameter of the conductor I am going to take into as capital D. Therefore, capital D is nothing but small d plus here 1t, here is 1t. Therefore, capital D is equal d plus t plus t. Therefore, capital D is equal small d plus 2t. So that is the formula here we got. The overall diameter of the coated conductor is capital D. So from the figure, here capital D is equal small d plus left side thickness and right side thickness. Therefore, capital D is equal small d plus t plus t. Therefore, capital D is equal small d plus 2t. If capital D is equal small d plus 2t, then the area of the coated conductor, that means area of the conductor, A is equal pi r square, actually formula. But A is equal area of the circle or area of this conductor, A is equal pi r square, but r is nothing but d by 2. R is nothing but radius. Radius is equal diameter divided by 2. If in the place of r, if I substitute that diameter d by 2 whole square, then it becomes d square divided by 2 square. Then it becomes pi d square divided by 4. If it is pi d square by 4, as already I know that capital D is equal small d plus 2t. If I am substituting in the place of capital D, then the above equation is simplified as like this, that is capital pi of small d plus 2t whole square divided by 4. So, and the area of ice covering, we can write that formula AI is equal pi by 4 of capital D square minus small d square. So, if we write that capital D square minus of small d square, the volume of ice is meter cube per meter length of the conductor. Then area of ice is in meter square of capital D and small d are in meters. Therefore, the density of ice is like 915 kg per meter cube. This already we know very clear. That is nothing but a basic value. The total weight of ice can be obtained as density of ice into, that is 915 into, area of ice covering. Therefore, area of ice covering is pi by 4 of d square, capital D square minus small d square. Therefore, density of ice is 915 into pi by 4 of capital D square minus small d square is nothing but the total weight of ice which is obtained, the mathematical formula as like this. That is Wi is equal 915 into pi by 4 of capital D square minus small d square kg per meter. The weight acts vertically downward direction. If the weight acts vertically downward direction, that is capital D is equal small d plus 2t. Then I am going to substitute capital D is equal small d plus 2t in this formula. Then Wi is equal 915 into pi by 4 of capital D. In the place of capital D, I am substituting that small d plus 2t whole square minus small d square. So here I can expand this formula as like a plus b whole square. I may get a square as d square, b square as 2t whole square. 2t whole square means 2 square t square. 2 square means 4. 4t square plus 2ab, 2 into 2t into d. 2 into 2t means 4t into d. So 4dt, t into d. So 4dt minus, already is there, minus d square. So from here, from the above equation, this equation, that is 915 into pi by 4 of small d square plus 4t square plus 4 into dt minus d square. Here plus d square minus d square get cancelled. The remaining equation is 915 into pi by 4 of 4t square plus 4 into dt. So if I am going to take that 4 as common at here, the above equation is once again simplified as 915 into pi by 4 into 4 into t square plus dt. Here 4, 4 get cancelled. The remaining equation here, it follows as 915 into pi t into d plus t of kg per meter. So in this equation, that is 915 into pi t into d plus t kg per meter. So the weight of ice, Wi is equal weight of ice per unit length, that is Wi is equal density of ice into pi t into d plus t of kg per meter. So in this formula, the density of ice is nothing but 915. If I am substituted that density of ice is 915, the remaining formula, that is weight of ice per unit length, Wi is equal the overall formula 915 into pi t into d plus t kg per meter. So this is that the overall formula for the weight of ice, because ice is forming as one of the layer on the top of the surface area of the conductor. So we have to take it into account. The overall formula is this one. Thank you.